Good morning, everyone. Hope we're all getting on the Zoom now. Want to welcome you all to the Warriors 5C seminar. I hope the next 5 weeks we get a lot out of this and become a stronger athletic department, and we help each team build a stronger culture. So just a reminder, our 5Cs is, we want to find great athletes with superior character who can establish an exceptional culture that will make a tremendous impact in the community by being fully committed to excellence, which will translate into championships. And today we're excited to start with character. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Taylor Hawkins.
Hi guys. For those of you guys who don't know me, my name is Taylor Hawkins. I am one of the SAC reps, and I am also an athletic coordinator here at Westcliff University. So I'm just going to tell you guys a little about the 5-week 5C challenge and let you know like how everything is going to be going from here. So each week on Tuesday, we will be having a Zoom meeting, the one that you guys are on now, and we're going to talk about the 5C of the week. So Coach Larson just went over the 5Cs, so you guys should know them. And then each week you guys are going to stack up points. So how you guys can earn points is from videos and photos that you post on IG or any of your guys' accounts. You just have to tag Westcliff. So this week is character. You need to post a video that shows character, and you can do whatever you want. So you can do a defining character. You can act out. You can do whatever you want to show you have character. You know what character is. You're demonstrating character. And then a photo, the photo pictures that you guys can upload have to be like when you're with your team. So if it's in the weight room with Sed, if you're doing morning workouts, it just has to be like a team workout activity. You post those pictures, tag Westcliff Athletics, and you should receive 10 points for each of those. Now you can post as many as you want. So you can post 5 videos a week if you want. You can post 5 pictures. You just, again, have to tag Westcliff Athletics, and it has to be by Friday by 3:00. Other ways you can earn points are going to events. So like SAC, for instance, if a SAC team has an event, you can go to the SAC event. The FCA events, you can go to those as well. You can only earn up to 20 points. So 2 people showing up, if you have 5 people, cool, you'll get 20 points for that. Let's see. Now I think I'm gonna pass it off. No, actually, we're gonna start with a quick icebreaker. Can you guys just put in the chat, what's your mood today? How do you feel today? What's today feeling like for you? I'll start. I guess I'm happy, kind of nervous. Okay, let's see. I have blessed, productive, grateful, tired, but good. Great. Thanks for asking. All right, cool. While you guys are doing that, also, can I have you guys just change your background to anything that like showing how you feel? If you're feeling happy, like you said, tired, you guys can change your virtual backgrounds to how you feel. I'll give you guys like a minute to do that. Let's see, loved by Coach Chelsea, okay. All right, I'll give you guys just a couple more seconds. And then from there, I'm gonna pass it off to Coach Larson, and he's gonna go over. Actually, I'm going to play a video. I'll have Liddy play a 5C video right now.
Welcome to Westcliff University in beautiful Irvine, California. Here, it is our mission to find great athletes with superior character
who can establish an exceptional culture
that will make a tremendous impact in the community
by being fully committed to excellence,
which will translate into championships.
These 5 C's
embody
all that we strive
to achieve.
right, great. Now I'm going to pass it over to Coach Larson, and he's going to go over the 5C of the week.
Okay, thank you, Taylor. So this week is character. Our definition is brought to us by Coach Harris, who helped build the 5Cs and brought it to us, is character. Encourage and empower student athletes to make decisions that are in line with the goals and core values of the university and the team. Someone I really connect with is John Gordon. If you have a chance to ever see John Gordon, and I got a quote here that I like from him that reminds us, just in terms of character, who we are and who we can be every day around our teammates, our coworkers, our professors, our friends. We are reminded every day that we are contagious. Well, I want to remind you that your love is contagious, your hope is contagious, your kindness is contagious. Your optimism, belief, and faith are positively contagious. So everything we do around Westcliff University and our athletics is contagious. Everything you do makes a difference in people's lives. So I'm not gonna keep talking because we have a video that is gonna talk about that in a much better way. His name is Inky Johnson, and Liddy is going to start that video for us and listen to him and his takes.
Be in this room, to be before you guys, I want to extend my gratitude not only to Coach Fulmer, he changed my life. I want to extend my gratitude to Coach Pruitt, his staff, for trusting me to bring me in to speak to you guys. You know, this place is very special to me. You know, I take it personal, right? When I watch a Tennessee game, right? I take it personal, right? When I watch us compete, right? And I'm gonna be honest with you. Like I said it in a video 3 years ago, and I meant it with every fiber of my being, right? When I said Tennessee don't take the back seat to nobody, right? Excuse my French, but I meant every bit of that shit, right? To nobody, to no man, right? Because in the essence of a man and who he is, like I believe football, all it is outside of the schematics and X's and O's, I've always believed this. I've never been the biggest, the fastest, the strongest. I've never needed to be. Right? Because I believe at the core of what it is it's my will versus your will. It's my bloodline versus your bloodline. It's what I represent versus what you represent. It's what I believe versus what you believe. Right? And so when I see this game and I look at it from the perspective that I view it through, right, the thing that hurt me the most when I got injured, it wasn't that my career ended. It wasn't that. Right? It's when I went to watch a game or watch a practice and you would see a cat that took it for granted and didn't appreciate it, right? Like, I'm from the school of thought. I can't understand how a cat can say they want something and not give everything they got to it, right? I'm from the school of thought. When a cat is a part of something, organization, team, brotherhood, and you look a man in his eyes and tell him you're gonna give him everything he got, and then the situation or the circumstances change, and then you allow your actions to betray your words, I can't understand or comprehend that. That's hard for me, right? Like when I first got to Tennessee my freshman year, like when I came on my visit, that was the first time I slept in a bed by myself, right? And they was trying to take me to a sorority party. And I'm like, man, take me to the Marriott. I got a king size bed. Like, I got a suite. And they're like, you ain't got a bed at home. I'm like, no, right? So when I got here, it meant something different to me. My mother was working a double shift at Wendy's when I got here. Had me at 16 years old. Came from a two bedroom home with 14 people. Inner city Atlanta, first one in my family to get a scholarship, right? So I was thinking legacy the whole time. And
what if you could grab industry-recognized certifications and endorsements for one of today's top universities?
Now, I'll never forget the first summer I got here, I was in my locker, and I saw one of my teammates come into the locker room, and he was saying as he was putting stuff in his locker, I quit, right? And he was throwing stuff in his locker, and I'll never forget, I stood up and I said to him, as a man, right? As a man, look me in my eyes and tell me you're not about to quit. Like, as a man, tell me you're not about to quit. Like, you're not about to wave the white flag and say, I yield. Like, tell me you're not about to fold. Tell me you're not about to go in a fetal position because the situation and the circumstance has gotten hard. Tell me you're not about to get to a campus and because you're not getting what you thought you was going to get, you want to go back home and you want to call your mother. Tell me you're not getting on campus and because they switch your position, you want to call your father and tell him to talk to a coach. Tell me you're not about to quit. And he's like, yeah, Ink, I'm about to quit. I said, why? I can't take the way they talking to me. I said, you're not 8, right? You're not 7, right? You're not a baby, right? He's like, nah, but I can't take the way they talking to me. I said, oh, you want them to treat you like the double tree. You want to check in, they give you 2 warm cookies, they pat you on your butt, they tell you good job for doing what you said you was going to do. Like, you want validation. And I asked him the question, I said, this isn't about your legacy? Like, you're not working every single day feeling as if when you do something, if you're blessed to reproduce, one day when somebody go up to your seeds or your children, because of how you did it, they're like, man, that's your father, you good, right? You don't want to do it in such a way that when somebody see you, they're like, man, if it has to be done, that is the way you do it. You're not doing it in such a way to when you do it, they're like, hey, you want to see how it's done? Let me turn on the tape so you can see this cat and see how he coming every single day, not inconsistency, right? Like, I was one, I didn't care about talent. Right? I didn't care about skill set, right? Because I understood talent and skill set might betray you along the journey if they don't have a consistency of mindset and they don't have a certain level of fortitude in every fiber of their being. At a certain point, you can have a cat that's talented or you can have a cat that has character and you know what he bringing to the table every single day, right? You got cats that's talented that tap out. Like, anybody can go 1 or 2 downs, right? Anybody can go 3 downs. But it's very seldom that you find a cat when he's standing in that tunnel till his 4-0s on that clock, he's gonna give you everything. That's a man to me, right? Most cats, little boys, right? They get what they want. I tell my son all the time, I'm like, Ink, it's a big difference between a hard worker and somebody that works hard, right? Most cats are somebody that works hard. If the situation and the circumstance is what they want it to be, they're gonna come out and they're gonna act accordingly and they're gonna give you everything they got. But a hard worker, regardless of situation, regardless of circumstance, regardless of what happened, I'm gonna show up and I'm gonna give everything I got to it because I'm working for something that's totally different, right? The question becomes this: can you be committed to the process of what you're doing without being emotionally attached to the results of what you're doing? Can you be committed to the process of what you're doing without being emotionally attached to the results of what you're doing? In other words, if you don't get what you thought you was gonna get, will you still be the same individual? If the situation don't turn out the way you thought it would turn out, will you still be the same individual? The quote says it, you judge the character of a man not by where he stands in times of comfort and convenience. You judge the character of a man by where he stands in times of challenge and controversy. Like, I don't care what a cat do when everything goes right. I don't, because everybody knows to smile. Everybody gonna celebrate when you win a game. Everybody gonna be in your corner and talking about how great you are. But when the opposition happens, when it gets hot, right? When cats don't want it and don't want to be a part of it. When things start going south and a cat jumps on your head and you're like, man, it's not what I thought it was, right? The crazy thing about it is most cats remind me of one of my freshman roommates when we first got our Pell Grant check, right? And I'll never forget, I got $2,500 and he got close to $4,000. And when I looked at him, I said, man, I ain't never had this much money before. He's like, me neither. I said, man, I'm going to the bank. I'm about to open up me an account. I'm gonna put this in the bank. My man says to me, Ink, I'm gonna go to Foot Locker. I'm about to spend all this. I'm like, all right, cool, but come with me to the bank, man. You need to save a little bit of that. I said, you might not get that much again. He's like, that's the problem. I said, come with me to the bank. He called me to the bank, open up an account. I put my money in the bank. He goes straight to the mall, exactly what he said he was gonna do. We walk in Foot Locker, let me get those J's. He's splurging. Right, we get to the counter, lady starts ringing it up. He gives her the card, she swipes the card, card didn't go through. He looked at me. I said, don't look at me, big spender. You the man. He said, ma'am, I know I got the money. Football office gave it to me. Can you swipe it again? She swiped it again. Card didn't go through. He looked at me. I said, don't look at me, big money tight grip. You the man. He said, ma'am, can you swipe it again? I know I got the money. She swiped it. Didn't go through. She handed him the card back. And I'll never forget, she said to him, sir, you haven't even pulled a strip off the back of the car to activate the card. She said, you got the money. She said, but you haven't even called to activate it. And when you look at some young cats, you're like, man, you could be great. But you haven't even pulled a strip off to activate it. Like, you could operate in a level of excellence in everything you do, but you haven't even pulled a strip off to activate it. right? You're living on reserve, and most cats live on reserve. And what I mean by living on reserve, most cats do things in such a way to where when they get to a certain point, their heart is like a Cadillac converter in a car. Right? You know what a Cadillac converter is? It's when you're in a certain car and you try to push it to the limit. And when it gets to the limit, the car says, And every time you try to mash it, the car, Because it hasn't been to that point before. And that's the heart of most cats. When they get to a certain point that they haven't been to before, they retreat. And it's not even about an opponent. It's not even about opposition. It's about, I've never been to that point before, and I don't know how I'm going to respond. They scared of themselves. It's not even about an opponent. You get some 18, 19, 20-year-old cats, they're scared of themselves. It's not about an opponent. They're standing in a tunnel in Neyland Stadium, getting ready to play in front of 100,000 fans, and they're questioning their integrity. Like, the reason I can live with what happened to me on September 9, 2006, the last play, is personal to me. Right? Because I knew when I went out, I gave my teammates everything I had. Like, I can look you dead square. I'm a man, right? I don't lie. Right? I don't fear no man. Right? From Tennessee, California, you could drop me anywhere on any place. I don't fear no man. Right? That's how I was raised. That's how I'm coming. Right? When I went out, my last play, I knew I gave my teammates everything I had. Every ounce of my spirit. Right? That's why when coach came to see me in the hospital, I'm like, I'm good. I empty everything out of me. Now, if I didn't give them everything I had, it would have been a big ounce of regret, because I would have lived my whole life with the thought of, man, what if I gave everything I had to it, right? I just want one thing from y'all, man. Like, when I played, right, I didn't care if a cat ran a 4-3. I didn't care about that. I didn't care if a cat go up in the weight room and bench press 500 pounds. Cat can lift the world. I ain't care about that. I ain't care if a cat did the L drill faster than him. I ain't care about that. I wanted a cat beside me that I knew was going to scrap. I wanted a cat beside me that I knew when we looked across they knew, man, cat can't see us, man. I wanted a cat beside me, no matter the outcome, we coming, we working, and we fighting until the game over. I wanted a cat beside me that had a certain level of consistency of mindset to understand how I do anything is how I do everything. And you meet most young cats, and they think it's a dual mentality, right? They think football is one mentality, life is one mentality. No, bro, it's you. It's your spirit. It's your essence. It's who you are. I never understood, to be honest with you, I never understood how a cat can tap out on a wind sprint. I never understood how a cat can quit on agility, like a cat in the facility and they getting smoothies. Cat got a barbershop. Like a cat getting his jock strap washed and got the nerve to step on the field and not give everything they got to it. Like a cat getting gear. A cat got a stadium, a cat got a locker. Like, how can you not scrap? How can you not fight for what you believe in? Like, I feel like it's a level of honor and responsibility that comes with that, right? When you come to this place, it's a privilege, right? You got cats that came before you, and they cherish this, right? They cherish it. When I got here, we cherish this place, right? When I got here, we believe we can beat anybody in the country. And the work ethic and the discipline and the dedication and the commitment wasn't based upon or predicated upon situations or circumstances, right? I'm talking concrete commitment, right? Not that commitment, I'm gonna show up, I'll be there, coach. Yeah, I'll go to meetings. Yeah, I'm gonna go out. I might run hard three sprints. Not that, man. Not that cheap stuff, man. Not that counterfeit stuff. I'm talking concrete commitment. I'm talking a commitment that says, I am going to stay true to what I said I would do long after the mood that I've set it in has left, right? Because when you're in them seats, it's easy to talk about what you're going to do, right? But Mike Tyson said it. Everybody got a plan until they get punched in the mouth. And some cats, when they get punched in the mouth, they never recover. Some cats, when they get hit in a way they never got hit before, they never recover. Some cats, when they get placed in situations and it challenges their character, they never recover. Some cats, when you ask more of them that's ever been asked of them before, they never recover. Right? Why can't we play football and operate in excellence? And why can't we go to the classroom and operate in excellence? Right? Like when he said I grabbed the cat, I grabbed him for one reason. Right? When I stepped in the cat's face, I wanted him to understand first and foremost, it's all love. I loved you. Right? I loved every one of my teammates. Right? but I understood at the core of what we were a part of, we had a purpose that was a lot greater than any one of us. Like the purpose and the thing that you're a part of is greater than any cat in here. I don't care how many stars you got. I don't care what high school you came from. I don't care what you the man. I don't care if you were All-American, Army All-American, McDonald. I don't care about none of that. When you get here, you're a part of something that's a lot bigger than you. It's cats that came through here before you, and it's going to be cats that come through here after you. And so while you're blessed to be able to do it, how about we do it in a way that it's never been done before, and we raise the standard of it, right? The standard is the standard. We don't lower it, right? We don't say, oh, man, we Tennessee. The standard is the standard. We compete, we fight, we scrap, we live to fight another day. We don't retreat against nobody. Right? We scrap, we fight, we live to see another day. We come out and we work for something that's a lot greater than a game of football. Right? My arm and my hand got paralyzed. My heart didn't. They saved my life Saturday. I was back in class Tuesday. I was back at practice with my teammates Wednesday. You could go to the, when you go to the training room, ask Jason McVay. They told me, Inc., we want to send you back to Atlanta. I said, nope, order me a Dunjoy sling and a Velcro strap. True story. He said, yeah, Inc., but something tragic happened to you. I get that. You're right. You're 100% right. Order me a Dunjoy sling and a Velcro strap. He said, why? I said, I'm going back to practice with my teammates. My career was over. And you got a cat that'll get an ankle injury, and he act like the world for them. You get a cat that get an ACL, like my man can't show up for nothing. Right? I told him, man, that wasn't a part of my contract. And when I speak about contract, not contract, I ain't have a college contract. I'm talking about my life contract. Like, I didn't say, I'm going to give you everything I got unless things go wrong and my career ends. I was in the sand pit running with my teammates in my sling. And I had staples. I had 300 staples in my body, as a matter of fact, and I was running sprints with them. It means something different to me, man. Like, I ain't one of these cats going to get up here and talk to you about no five ways to success. I lived it. Ain't one of these cats gonna get up here and talk to you about something that ain't there. I sat in them seats, right? It means something different to me, right? Like I firmly believe, like Eric Berry is somebody to me that's like a little brother to me, right? And I'll never forget when I got the call about him having cancer, right? Great man, right? Did things the right way, hard worker. But I never forget I got the call about him having cancer. And one day when he was leaving chemo, he said to the cats, take me to the track. Right? And they're like, man, you just left chemo. Like, I get that. Take me to the track. Like, man, you just left chemo. It's like, now I gotta do my routine. I gotta go run my 400s. And he said, as he was running his 400s, he was crying and he said, I'm crying not because I'm in so much pain. I'm crying because I'm not who I used to be, but I know I'm gonna come back one day stronger than I used to be. And he came back that season. He was comeback player of the year, defensive player of the year. And it's all she wrote. That ain't talent. As talented as he is, talented as he was, that ain't talent. That's essence. That's core. That's who I am as a person. That's how I get down. That's how I'm coming. That's what that is, right? Never forget, man, who you are as a man is far more important than who you are as a football player. And every time you get ready to stop, every time you get ready to quit, that's you as a man. That's not you as a football player. But when you press forward in the midst of the opposition, in the midst of the adversity, think about it in terms of this. You're not just building a mentality for the game of football. You're building a mentality that's going to sustain you 20, 30, 40, 50 years from now. When you're trusted with something that's a lot greater than you. When you're trusted with something that's a lot greater than a defensive huddle. Right? I just want one thing from you, man. I just don't want you to take this thing for granted. Most importantly, I want you to understand what you got, right? Because I'm a straight shooter. I know it's some young cats in here thinking right now, they the sweetest of the sweet and can't nobody tell them nothing. And then when they get hit with the first sign of adversity, they going upstairs to the transfer portal. Not because they ain't talented enough, right? Not because they ain't got it, right? But because they can't sustain and they can't stick through the opposition. And when it gets tough, they camp out, they wave the white flag, and they say, I don't want it. You got to get cats with you, man, that's in the midst of the opposition, in the midst of adversity. You know what you're fighting for, and you know what you're working for. right? People don't burn out in life because of what they do. People burn out because life makes them forget why they do it. Go back and do some soul searching and think about when you first started, what was it about, right? And don't allow the politics to take your passion. If they want to switch your position, roll with it, right? If you're not getting the playing time, you won't put yourself in a position to become undeniable, so they got to play you. Don't call home to mama. It's too late. Let her do what she do. Don't get here and call your daddy and talk about daddy, come bail me out. It's too late. Put your big boy britches on. Let's go to war. Let's work, right? Because we got a common purpose and we got a common goal. And what we represent is far more bigger than us, right? I'm going to tell you this. I got it when I was here and we went on a team trip. And I saw an older gentleman. Right, we went to do some little volunteer work. And we out there volunteering Habitat for Humanity, and we going to get on the bus. And as we get on the bus, it's an older gentleman sitting across the street in a wheelchair. He waving us down. Me and a couple of my teammates run across the street, we greet him. How you doing, sir? I'm great. He said, man, do y'all know the way y'all play football dictates the way my day goes. He said, if y'all lose, but y'all fight, I feel like I can fight. He said, when y'all give up, when y'all quit, my day is ruined. I'm telling you that so you can understand what you're a part of and what you represent and what you're playing for. It's a blessing to play the game of football. It's a privilege to play it at the University of Tennessee. I'm gonna say it again, because I don't want you to ever forget it. It's a blessing to play the game of football. It's a privilege to play it at the University of Tennessee. Let's never take this thing for granted, fellas. We gonna scrap, we gonna fight, and we gonna live to fight another day. Thank you for your time. God bless you, man. Pleasure.
All right, a few words from Coach Larson.
Okay, so let's get everybody involved in this. So as we watch this, I want you guys to, in the chat, just put a couple words. I'm going to start it because this is what I see when I listen to Inky Johnson. Okay. You know, he brings this up, and that's the emotional connection. And there's no doubt that you want to be that successful in sports and in life. And he talks about his legacy is that emotional connection with your teammates, your coaches, your friends, your family. You will have a lot less regrets when you make that emotional connection. So if you can, go ahead and just type in a word or two that makes you think, what does character mean to you? And go ahead and do that now. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Coach Larson. While you guys are doing that, I just want to give a reminder. So after the 5 weeks, the grand prize, I didn't go over the grand prize. The grand prize is the team bonding event of your choice. So you guys can pick anything you guys want, whoever the winner is, and it will be sponsored by the AD team. So coming up next, we're going to do a Kahoot. Before we start the Kahoot, I just want to let you guys know, whatever name you guys put, please put like your team. So like if it's Taylor, women's basketball, Taylor, WBB, whatever team you're on, put that on there so we can know who to give the points to. So we're going to take the top three people. We'll collect the points from them. So get ready. We're going to start the Kahoot right now. Thank you. wait a couple more seconds and then we'll start the game. Like, we have 85 people on the call. Let's try to at least get to like 60 people playing. Let's see if we can get a couple more people. We have, again, 86 people on the call. Maybe let's get to like 45 at least. Great definitions of character. I like it. All right, let's try to get at least three more people to get to 40. We're at 37. All right, we're gonna start now. All right, Character Kahoot. First question, true or false? True or false, the NAIA core values are integrity, respect, responsibility, sportsmanship, and servant leadership. All right, that looks like that's true. Those are the core leadership. Core values, sorry. Looks like we have women's soccer in first place, baseball second. All right, students entering their second, third, and fourth seasons need how many credit hours to be certified as eligible? So how many hours do you need to be eligible? Your sophomore year, junior and senior. The answer is A, season two, 24, 36 for season three, 48 season three, 72 season four. Okay, next question. All right, what year was Westcliff University founded? Eighteen eighty-three, 1912, 1993 or 2006? That is correct, 1993. All right, looks like men's soccer is in the lead. What is the Westcliff University mascot? Are we the Westcliff Wildcats, Westcliff Warriors, Westcliff Wallabies, or Westcliff Warthogs? Yes, we are the Westcliff Warriors. Great job, guys. Looks like men's soccer is still in the lead. True or false, Anthony Lee is the president of Westcliff University. So that, yeah, that is true. Our president is Anthony Lee. Looks like men's soccer is still in first place. Then we have softball in second. All right, who is Sean Harris? Is he the head men's basketball coach at Westcliff? Is he the quarterback of the Pittsburgh Steelers? Is he the head baseball coach at Westcliff University? Or is he the dean of athletics at Westcliff University? Yes, he is the dean of athletics. You all should know that by now. All right, it looks like softball is in first. Men's soccer is in second. Women's basketball is in third. True or false, black is one of Westcliff University's school colors. That answer is false. The colors are gold, blue, and white. All right, softball, you're in the lead. Which team is not playing in the 2021 Super Bowl? Is it the Kansas City Chiefs, the Chicago Bears, or the Tampa Bay Buccaneers? That is correct. The Chicago Bears are not playing in the Super Bowl this weekend. The Westcliff Warrior definition of character is to encourage and empower students to make decisions that follow the Westcliff values, create opportunities to improve relations between and among teams, to have high ethical standard, to create an environment that inspires challenges. All right, yeah, A was the correct answer. Looks like men's soccer is back on top. Integrity and the NAIA 5 core values means treat others the way you want to be treated, bring your best to all competitions, know and do what is right, serve the common good. The correct answer is know and do what is right. Which of the following is not one of the five C's? Champions, championships, courtesy, character, or community? All right, courtesy is not one of the five C's, even though you should practice that as well, though. Who is the starting quarterback for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and Super Bowl, whatever that is? Tom Brady. I'm sure everyone's heard of him. All right, looks like men's soccer is still in first place. How many countries are represented by Westcliff students? 92 countries, 87, 71, 56? All right, it looks like there's 87 countries represented by Westcliff students.
Last two questions.
In 2020, how many students were enrolled at Westcliff University? This is not just student athletes, this is overall students. That looks like there's 3,168 students at Westcliff University.
Final question.
Men's soccer in the lead still. The average temperature in Irvine, California is 78, 68 degrees, 73, or 81 degrees. All right, 73 degrees every day in Irvine. Perfect. All right, third place, is that cheer I see? I think we have cheer. Second place, softball. And first place is men's soccer. Great job, guys. Those will be added to your score. Runner up, I think we have women's volleyball. All right, perfect. I'm just gonna give out a couple more reminders before the end. Remember, you can earn points throughout the week, again, with the video challenges. You can post as many as you want. They're worth 10 points by Friday at 3:00. That's the last time you can submit. And then also the photos. Also, we do have our SAC chats every Thursday, and we do have FCA meetings and any events coming up in the next 5 weeks. Please attend and you can receive points for your teams. Thank you. Now I'm gonna pass it off to Coach Larson for some closing remarks.
Thank you, Taylor. Just wanna thank everybody for joining us today. Hope to see you, and even more, really encourage your teammates to join us next Tuesday. We're gonna focus on culture next week, and every week we're gonna have different people lead it, assistant coaches and people that maybe you haven't met. So you have a chance to meet different people in our athletic department. So once again, thank you. Have a blessed week. Hope to see you tonight, FCA at 5:30, and SAC and all the other events we have. Join in and be a part of it. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much for coming. Have a great day.